Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm uploading about LangChain and the different use cases I will talk about chatbots. Let's go. So I prepare an output as usual that later I will post into the repository. I give you some relevant links about the topic and also I include some additional link to a technology that is also mentioned in LangChain. They are referring to there is a search engine, a search API that's similar to Google or DuckDuckGo but specialized in LLM and RAG. As you may know, chatbots, the same that QA is one of the main use cases at the time that we do interaction with the LLMs, and then it's very common and well one of the most popular use cases to work and to develop the applications with LLMs. Here you had I took that is from LangChain, also some a little bit how is the workflow of the chatbot. Probably most of you are familiar, and on a daily basis we are interacting with chatbots. Doesn't matter that they are backed at with LangChain and OpenAI, like in the case that I will show you in this notebook or not. But it's something that is well, there is already I will say a mature technology behind there, and the introducing LLM and some of the and LangChain and the retrieval tools is providing a very powerful tool that that allow to well to have the very useful very useful component in your company or that will help you to solve many use cases. So a little bit the workflow is not all the components are really necessary. You can build the most simple chatbot is simply an LLM where you will raise a question and the LLM gives you an answer. Memory, well, if you want to LLMs, as you may know, they are stateless, so in any case if you want to deploy a chatbot like this, it will be a little bit, how to say, I wouldn't say useless, but the LLM per se is not going to keep any track of what you were discussing, no? And this is not how it was usually a conversation, for example, in between a subject matter expert or a doctor, and usually you start from something very general, and you usually narrow down the conversation after you get what you want to the information that you want to obtain, either from a specialist, for a special worker, whatever who is you are interacting with. In this case, it's a chatbot, it's a machine behind, and but the way how a conversation usually works is like that. No? You start from something very general, and then you start to narrow down the and refining the questions according to the answer that you receive from the specialist. From the specialist, and then the way to do that is obviously implementing a memory. If you don't want to do it, again, every time that you make a query, a question to the LLM, the LLM is going to answer you, but it's not gonna remember what you asked it before. The way to solve that is how I told you, is creating a buffer memory. You can cache, you can name it different ways, and this memory you will keep the messages and the conversation that you are having with the LLM, and this will give you a context to the LLM to answer you according to what you are asking or the question that you made before. And then another tool that you can also introduce in the as a to help the LLM to answer correctly and even answer more specifically to the to the question that you are doing in a specific topic is retrieval tools, which specifically you are introducing a context or additional information to the system, information that most likely was not included on the data that was used to train the model. You probably know as well that the models, any model, whatever the provider is trained at a some date, some day is released, and the information that we use to train that model is up to some specific day. Everything that happened after that, the model is that the model doesn't know, is not aware of that. No? And then in order to provide this information to the model, not only to specialize or to provide better answers, we use retrieval tools. No? And then this way we will see later on how we can do that. No? This is a very general question that with the name RAG, retrieval augmentation generation, this is how to say, a technology that help the LLMs in this case to provide first of all more specific answers according to a topic that the LLM may know but not as such detail, and secondly providing you also information that is happens, no, or happens after the moment that the model was trained. And okay, I give you again some of the relevant links from launching documentation that you can consult. They explain everything in really detail. It's quite well documentation. And well, here I will explain some of the main topics and then with some examples. I took from different places, and then you can replicate later on this on your own environment and in local. Again, I will push this notebook and you can try yourself later on. So we were in Colab, no need for GPU today, and then we installed the libraries that we need. As you see here, we are installing LangChain, TikToken. This is the library to count tokens according to an OpenAI model. We are working with OpenAI in this series of videos, but you may want to work with other, it's up to you. I want it just to be agnostic for that. It's not the matter to now review how the models how the model LLMs works in this case scenario. We are looking at LangChain. We mount the drive, we get the keys from the secrets, and we start here with we import the necessary libraries to create the basic chatbot. No? So we create, using the chat OpenAI class, we create an object with some temperature, GPT 3.5 turbo, and the key. We are using this model for all these videos. And then we have three roles, you want to say that on the chat, in a chatbot. One is the system, you can say it's like the role that is overseeing the whole interaction in between the user and the machine. You can also know this like metadata, because it's like saying, okay, you are a chatbot which is specialized in something, for example, in medicine, in giving a diagnostic, specializing in IT questions, IT support, something like that. It can be something general, like you are a helpful assistant. By default, the chatbot, once you initialize it, has something similar to this. No? Something very general, but you can probably write something more narrow to the or more close to the to the definition or to the task that the chatbot is going to answer and to in which the chatbot is specialized. We also had basically the mesh placeholder is essentially a place where we are going to put messages. Messages can come from the user side, which we know as human messages. This is a class as well in LangChain, and we had the IA messages. This is the answers from the LLM. So here we are going to do the basic example. It's just we create a chain with a chatbot, with our template, with our prompt template, which is including again the system messages and the placeholder for messages. Here this is going to be a stateless. No memory, and then you will see what is exactly the effect and how we can solve it in a few seconds. So you just send an instruction to the chatbot. I want to translate this to German, and obviously the GPT, this is correct, it leaves no burden, it's translated correctly to German, and then on you call again the chat and you just ask what did you say, and then on the obviously here for the model, this is a new query. It's not connected with what you asked before, and then he's again answered you but with something that is not completely related, as you can see here. And then to solve this, as I mentioned before, we need to create this memory, this cache, whatever you want. To create this cache, you need to consider always the Windows context of the model. So depending the model that you are using to interact to create the chatbot, this is bigger, longer or slower. OpenAI model used to have very long Windows context. And why I told you this, because well, you can introduce all the conversation that you had with the model every time, and then doing that way you are giving obviously all the context of your conversation to the model, but at the same time you step by step reduce the ability of the model to answer you something, no? Even if you will get a point where the model will not be able to answer you anything because it overflows the window context. You are consuming all the space that the model had as input, no, for that message. So the way to do that, we will see it a little bit later, is probably just want to send the model the latest two or three questions that you formulate, the latest two or three questions that you formulate with the two or three answers as the LLM give you, because they are the most relevant for the question you are asking right now. And again, this is how usually a conversation works. You go from the general to the specific, and then on what you ask, for example, 10 questions before, probably is not going to have any impact, no? Or it's probably too general, and then the conversation is always driven by the user and the answer that the LLM is giving you in one direction, and then what you happen 10 questions before probably is at this moment completely irrelevant. That's why this designing how many questions and answers of the LLM you send in every message to the bot is a technique that you need to, well, depending on the use case, as well if you are introducing context or a retrieval tool that is looking for information in a database or on the web, you will need to be aware of this how much memory you introduce in every call that or query that you make to the model. So now how we do that, we create the model, Exactly, that's what happened here, sorry. And then one very simple way to overcome this is just introduce on the message, as you see here, when we invoke the call to the LLM, is including the first message, the human message, the answer. This is what the LLM answer us, and also the next question. In this case, the model is aware of what happened, because you are giving the context here in the prompt, and then the model is able to answer you correctly. As said, it leaves snowboarding, which means I love snowboarding in German. That's correct. So usually what we implement is a buffer, as I said. There is an object, chat message history. There is some others. You can review the documentation. I put you a link about of this notebook, and then but this is the simple one, is you just add to a this is simply a list. It's a class, but essentially it's implementing a list where you are adding every message from the human, every human message and every AI message that you receive from the LLM to this buffer, to this history, to this list, and you are sending, instead to send a human message to the LLM, you send the chat history, where you are appending all these messages when you invoke a call to the chain, to the LLM. You can see here the sample. We make the same, translate this sentence, and then we are adding a user message to the history, and then we send to the LLM the query, and we send the history, and then on here is leave snowboarding, and then we add now to the history the response, and we add the new question, and then on again. This is exactly the same that we did here, but using a buffer, a history buffer, no? So we part this a little bit. We will come back later and see and continue with this topic. Now we touch the retrievers. Retrievers is well tools which help us to introduce new information into the conversation, no? As I mentioned before, you may want to specialize your bot in a specific topic. It's exactly what we are gonna do here. And also, you can also probably want to give the models some additional information because of the topic I mentioned before. Models were training up to a specific day, and from that day onwards, they are not able to answer you. They may hallucinate and answer you whatever, but probably false or wrong. And in order to avoid these kind of things, we provide new information, fresh information. We introduce it into the loop, and we allow the we provide this context and this new information. We introduce it into the conversation, and the model, we use the capabilities of the model to use this information and answer you correctly according to the context that you are providing with this new information that you introduce into the loop. So we are going to use here a new loader. We look in previous videos the text loader, the PDF loader, and also pandas or CSV loaders. Today we are going to look at the web-based loader. Web-based loader, the name is self-explanatory. We work with URLs, and then what it's doing essentially is retrieve the HTML and transform the HTML into a LangChain document. And then I'm going to specialize the model in Anthropic. Anthropic is the company which developed Claude. Claude is also a series of models. We will make a video or send some of videos about the Claude series of LLMs. Also very interesting stuff, but it's not the matter to discuss today. We will look at, and then how you do it. You can simply send one link, or you can send multiple links. Essentially, what it's gonna do, the web-based loader, is retrieve all these web pages and transform it to text, and later to LangChain documents. You can see here I pass all these links that essentially is the documentation of the cloud. For those that don't know, is a very well, it's a well-known model with a very long window context, specialized in tasks like summarization. Is one of the best in that matter, and well, they can do many other things, as you see here, text generation, vision as well, multimodal embeddings. Yeah, we will look at this in another moment. Just what I want to show you, I just pass some of the links just to get context. And why I did it with Claude 3, sorry, is because Claude 3 was announced very like 1 week ago, and then obviously GPT 3.5 Turbo was not aware of the Claude 3. Probably even Anthropic was not even there. I don't know, 2021, I don't know. Maybe Claude was at the beginning, the first Claude family at the beginning, but for sure GPT 3.5 Turbo didn't know anything about the source, about Claude 3. You can make that very, very simple in probably we can do it. You can ask about Claude 3 in your OpenAI account in the playground, and if you probably the Claude 3 using the GPT 3.5 Turbo, they don't know anything about this or about what is Claude 3. Probably it will invent something, but because again, this information was not available when the GPT 3.5 Turbo was trained, and obviously it can invent it. This is the hallucination problem, but what it's gonna tell you is completely wrong. So I introduced these links just to get all information or some information from Anthropic, and then I load it, and then as you see here, one of the documents is just here, the loader is just going to retrieve all these URLs. Per URL is going to create a LangChain document. And you see here also the meta in the metadata. You saw the other videos, tags, the text, the records, the PDF loader, the text loader had different metadata. Here you can see we had the URL, the source, the title of the page, and the language. And then I say, as I said in, as I explained you in other videos, you can enrich this metadata with some other, how to say, attributes, kind of feature engineering, where you later can use this, depending as well of the tool that you are using to query the, in this case, the vector store. You had a tool like Pinecon, you will be able to use this metadata to refine the query when you try to query the information that you will have in the vector store. So, but well, as I said, the web-based loader will create a document based on every web page, and then with the recursive character splitter, we will create chunks of these pages in order to later create embeddings, and these embeddings will be used as a context for our chatbot. So we are here creating again here the size of the chunk. Again, I return to the topic of memory management, how big you create the chunks, how big is going to be the context. This is something that you need to consider according to the LLM that you are using. OpenAI models had a very long context window, Claude as well, but if you are using, for example, Llama 2 or other, or even smaller models, they had a smaller window, and then you need to adapt this to, how to say, to the model that you are working on. So if you provide a very long chunk site, and then on you provide a context with four documents, four chunks, the more relevant to the question that you are gonna do, you are gonna ask to the LLM, you are consuming a lot of the context window, and then on the model had less possibility to give you a rich answer, no? And then on this is something that you have to play with, no? And then we have here 124 splits. We are going to work with Chroma. For the purpose of this experiment is more than enough, and we work with OpenAI embeddings. We load the embeddings into the Chroma database, and then on here just we are questioning directly to the vector store a question, and this retrieving by default is working with cosine similarity, retrieving the four more close vectors to this question. And then this is exactly what is gonna do the chatbot, no? Is will you make a question, the chain is gonna retrieve the closest documents from the vector store to the question that you are doing, and the chain will use LangChain will use these documents to provide context to the LLM to answer you according to your question and the context that you are providing. This is essentially what RAG is doing, and pretty well, very very spread use, not only in chatbot, also in QA systems. Here, to do this, we will use this class, which essentially is taking, introducing in the in the creating a chain which has the model. The model is the chat model, and also we have the question and answering prompt. Question and answering prompt is the template together with the placeholder, also the system, and then on we create the history, and then on, at the time the we create the object chat message history, we add the first message, so we had the vector store which is going to host all the context documentation for the LLM. And we had the message history, the buffer to host to keep all the conversation that we had with the LLM. So now we invoke the chain, and then we send the chain of messages, and we pass a context as context the docs. Here again, what is gonna do this class, create a start document chain, is sending the most relevant document or documents to the question that you are formulating here, no? Which model are available in Anthropic. And then on here, as you see here, the model already answered you with the Claude 3 family. Again, this is if you don't provide this question, and which you can try yourself with just using and asking the model without the context, what will happen if you answer without the context, no? You can try with your own topics, and you can experiment as much. So how to this create a, in this case late a retrieval chain which automatize all this stuff is how I explain you here in the next couple of cells. We just create a parser, and the parser is going to how to say, take the message, the content message that you receive as an answer, and pass this to the retriever. The retriever is going to contact with the vector store, no? And then once we do it that way, we retrieve the retrieval chain. We invoke the retrieval chain in this way, and you will see here that you had a more rich response, and the response is containing for one side the prompt with the message, the context. This is the four close documents to the question that you are formulating here, and in the answer, the response also contains the key answer, contains three keys mainly: message, context and answer. Okay, so you see here with the class whenever we pass through, we assign to the context what we pass from the retriever. Okay? So we pass to this function what we get from the retriever. The retriever is essentially calling, invoking a search into the vector store with the asking the vector store to return the four four closest documents, closest documents to the question that you formulate to the LLM. And then with this, it creates the answer with you see here. Okay. And then on what happened with this approach, that well, now you can continue and refine. This is again what usually happen in a conversation. You add the answer of the model to the buffer, and then you ask a new question. So you want to know a little bit more, refine the information, refine or going into one direction to understand. For example, tell me a bit more about Claude 3, which kind of models. You can again, you can try yourself. And then on here, you see now in the message, we are sending the buffer, we send the context, and we get an answer with this more detailed according to the context that you provide. No? What problem we have here with this approach? The problem is that every time now you may want to do another question to the chat, you will include in this design that we have here, you include the response from the model. You make another question, but the context that you are going to provide is the same. You are not retrieving new information. The information that you retrieve is from the initial initial query that was which model are available in Anthropic. So if you, for example, now ask about a specific model in Anthropic, like Claude or some other multimodal model, so the context that the chain will use in this design, it will be the same context that you had from the initial call, and it obviously is not optimal. The model is not having, I will say, fresh information or narrowed information according to your next question, and this will be deteriorating as much, so far you are progressing the conversation with the model. And then to avoid that, we had this other design option with this query transformation. And here, what you are doing is just provide the model with the relevant information according to the question that you are formulating at that time. What is not relevant, you don't pass as a context to the model for that question. This is also also relevant because, so again, here with this approach, we will just send the LLM the information that they need to answer the current question, and then you will see here now this how it works. We send the first question, and then in the first question we just had this message, we had this context. And then on we get the answer. So here in response we had the answer. We get the answer. We get the context, the document that we use for this question, and this is the second question. Now we add the next question, we invoke again we make a call again to the message, and we get a different answer. If you look at now the context is going to be different than the context that we have here. You see here, for example, state of the art is there, model source, and trophy language, model overview. Here we have the state of the art, but the second is already different. It's not model source, it's introducing an HNX club, blah blah blah. The third is club 3 model family has advanced, blah blah blah. Here is different, and also the fourth one. So this way we are selecting every time that we make a query to the a question to the bot, we select the most relevant information to help the from the vector data store to help the LLM to answer you correctly. Again, you can take a look to the documentation. There are multiple examples of how we can do that. No, and then, but I think that this is probably combining the buffer and combining how the retrieval tool is going to work. We can get really precise answers of the, from the model. We use the capabilities of the model. Obviously, it's a GPT. The 3.5 Turbo is very capable model, but doing that way we help even additionally the model to provide even better answers. And then now we are going to try this Tabili engine share. It's also fully integrated with LangChain. As you see here in LangChain community, we just create again. If you work before with or you were previously with DuckDuckGo search or Google search, it's exactly the same. They say that they are specialized in, let me show you LangChain, where is that, Agitabili. So they are specialized in doing web search, but with the objective to provide this information to LLMs and to be used as RAG tools. But under the hood, the models is using as well, where I found this, sorry. DuckDuckGo, Google API, and Google Share or ShareX. So under the hood is using at the end the one of the search engines available on the market. They provide they probably make a filtering and they provide some other value improving the search or narrowing the search to specifically what is going to help to the model, no? So we create this as a tool, the Tabili search results. This is a slightly different design. We create the chat object, the chat OpenAI object, and here we just have a placeholder for message for the message and a placeholder for the tool, for the Tabili tool, Tabili agent search engine. Here we create the chain slightly different, with the LLM, with the tool, and also with the prompt. And then on here you initiate the LLM with the message, with a message. Well, this is just a joke. And then the LLM is assisting you. Yeah, it's answering you with how can I assist you? Well, it's by default. I didn't create a system message. Well, yes, I created something. Here when we invoke you, well, I just ask a message as well. This information was not available at the time that GPT 3.5 Turbo was trained, because Giorgia Meloni, the Prime Minister of Italy, got into power around about October, November, I don't remember exactly when. And then on, when you answer, when you make the query, what it's doing is making a search in internet and finding the relevant information. You get here the link all the information, the link and the information that she use, or the tool use to provide the context to the LLM and to build the final answer. And here, well, I was a little bit surprised, to be honest, that they can use other links more recent, but they decide to use this. This is probably one of the added values that provide Tabily, that is looking to the probably to the information which is more close to the question that you probably can change this to who is the prime minister of Italy, and you can introduce, for example, at some specific timestamp, and probably at that, in that moment it will provide as well a link to a place where had other information more close to the timestamp that you are posting there. It's up to you to play and investigate a little bit more and play around how this is gonna work. No? Here to test this, I just also create another question, and I ask about the war in between Russia and Ukraine, and then here also answer me with another URL. But the interesting thing that now, even that the link you see here, the link is referring to the day that the war of this blob was started. It's true, it was started at this day, the war in between Russia and Ukraine, but what they return is a interactive link, no? And this link was updated we are 20 of March 2024, so it was updated just 1 week ago. So it's an interactive link, it's a feed, no? So again, it's doing really good job, no? And then you can go here, no? So in the exactly we are in the, that's probably 107 width of the wall, and yeah, so the information that is providing is really good. And okay, there is many things that you can do, as you can see, and then one of the key things is what I want to tell you is that you necessary for chatbots, also for Q&A tools or Q&A tools, introduce always context and new information into the system. There is multiple ways to do that. We will cover this with a specific video, what I wanted to show you is how to integrate this with the chatbot, and you guys just see here that is really really interesting, really nice how it works. And well, to be fair as well, LangChain made here a very very good job integrating many. They had a very extended landscape of tools that you can integrate and use to for different purposes, and one of these is this, it's doing very 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 good job. And again, here with the example of the Anthropic and Claude 3, impressive what they are doing. Yeah. Ah, well, that's all. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching my channel. And if you like the content, as I used to say, just give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you. See you soon.